Cecil Scott, one fall, 10-man tag team bout. How glad are you right now that you are not referee Robbie Walsh?
Man, the state of Robbie Walsh, but he has definitely got his hands full because I don't think I've ever seen a more eclectic group of 10 wrestlers in my life.
Aaron Biggs and Jason Miller starting it off. They have been at odds ever since Battlecade.
Yeah, Miller and Richards have been getting in the business of Aaron Biggs and Chris Showsmooth Lee.
Oh, that would not have been good if it had worked. And Miller went to tag Kandrak, and Kandrak absolutely left Miller hanging on the tag. It's going to be Nick Richards then.
I don't think Ray Kandrak's got a lot of patience for anybody on his team, to be quite honest.
No, or anyone on the planet for that matter.
Hey, you know what? If I'm Ryan Zane, I'd stay as far away from Ray Kandrak as possible. And nobody wants a piece of Aaron Biggs.
I wouldn't either. 400 plus pounds, the rampaging rookie.
Ryan Zane told me in the back that he loves chocolate. What do you think he means by that?
Well, Easter's coming up. It could could be Easter. You know, Easter candy.
I love Easter candy. Got some Cadbury eggs.
Maybe.
Yeah, if you had one of those Twix eggs yet.
This is no.
They're amazing.
This is a very interesting stylistic matchup as well.
Yeah, that's one way of putting it. Ryan Zane with that Pat Patterson go behind. Yeah, I brought that one back. Very fleet of foot is Ryan Zane.
Well, he's going to need to be evasive against Aaron Biggs because Biggs goes right about 400 or so pounds. And yeah, if he gets a hold of you, he's going to do something like that. Oh, boy.
He let up on him.
I think he has really thrown Biggs off his game.
They don't do that in the hood where Aaron Biggs is from.
Tagging to Matt Houston and Manny Garcia. Ryan holding the ropes open for his partner, Manny Garcia.
He told me Manny Garcia was going to be his partner for life. Man, this team.
Garcia and Matt Houston. Now the legal men.
Manny Garcia, he needs to pick his battles a little better, I think.
Well, I think he was a diversionary tactic, and I think it worked.
Oh, you're right. And Manny Garcia, don't let the act fool you. He really is as tough as they come.
And doesn't like getting hit, though.
No, he hates it.
He's not tough like Kandrak is tough. He's not tough like Bobby Wolford's tough.
He's deceptively tough.
Mm-hmm.
You got to remember, he pushed Corey Edsel and Eric Royal both to the limit this year.
Uh-oh, double team offense. No, Garcia's not going to let him have it. Garcia is fighting for everything he's worth here. Oh, but they muscled him up.
I think they underestimated how big Garcia is when they went for that move. But he's got very long limbs.
Yeah, Garcia goes about 6'4", 6'5".
Yeah, big, big kid is Manny Garcia.
Oh! Woo! He's got that developmental talent height.
Yeah.
And right now, he's getting rattled by the Outlaws.
Well, his chest isn't going to develop anymore if he keeps getting chopped like that.
Big Jimmy Parker tags in for the first time, and it's Parker against Garcia.
And this is one big hoss tag team.
Yeah, no doubt.
It's bad when Rick Converse might be the smallest guy on the team.
Garcia makes a tag, I think, to Kandrak. And speaking about people that have been rivals for months, it was Jimmy Parker's CWF Mid-Atlantic return back in December when he and Kandrak were on opposing sides and Richards just tagged himself in.
I don't know what Richards is taking here. Of course, Ray didn't argue with him a whole lot.
Look, Kandrak notoriously does not really like having partners so much. Like, he's a part of the All-Stars, but you'll notice a lot of times he's not fully involved in a lot of the All-Star six-mans and things of that nature. Kandrak really likes to work on his own unless the situation absolutely calls for it. So I'm pretty sure a team like this is not Kandrak's first choice of assignments tonight here at the Night of Champions.
No, and his face is very standoffish. It tells the whole story. And the big man, Jason Miller, back in.
A lot of big men in this matchup. Gonna try to double team Parker here. Oh, Parker runs right through him. Hard to stop that big hoss, Cecil Scott.
Yeah, Jimmy Parker's a big, stout guy.
And he's got a hold of Miller, and Miller right now is in the wrong part of town with the six-time Mid-Atlantic champ tagging in.
I swear, Parker gets bigger every time I see him. And Rick Converse, the fine wine of CWF Mid-Atlantic. He's like a Merlot.
Don't let Ryan Zane hear you say that. He'll take it too far.
Ooh.
You know, these two have no strangers to each other at all. When Miller was a rising Generation League talent, he and Converse went back and forth for months in a very heated rivalry. Converse finally takes Miller down off his feet.
Yeah, these two battled for quite a while. It was really how Jason Miller made his name against Rick Converse. Nice reversal there. Oh, and there's the veteran savvy of Rick Converse. And I think we're going to see a lot of covers in a match like this.
Yeah, one fall with a 20-minute time limit. So you got to think, in a 20-minute time limit, guys have got to have their game plan together. Guys have got to work together as a team, string something together, and make it happen.
Ooh, the meaty thud in the chest.
Matt Houston is in. Woo!
And they are going to light up Jason Miller.
This is exactly what I meant by the wrong part of town.
A nice European uppercut. Change it up a little bit. Lewis Moore is not going to do an uppercut.
Miller furious in the apron, but he's got four people surrounding him here. Okay. Outlaw is one of the most proficient teams in the Mid-Atlantic. Double shoulder tackle? Yes, sir.
Ooh, nearly took Miller out of his boots.
Outlaws work so well together, C-Bear. We have said for some time now how they're just a little bit away from stringing together that run that we've always knew they had in them to one day be Mid-Atlantic Tag Team Champions. For whatever reason, injuries, you know, what have you, they've just never quite made it there. But this is a team that for years now has been right on the cusp of championship glory in CWF Mid-Atlantic.
Yeah, it's always just one thing or another, just a little bad luck here and there. Just whatever it takes is to kind of stop their momentum every time.
It was not long ago they took Mecca and McAllister to the limit. It just didn't quite happen. Mecca's so big and so strong. When 440 pounds lays on you, that's pretty much the end of the bout.
Yeah, I don't care who you are. But the story here, Matt Houston just got his shoulder rammed twice in the post.
Houston is hurting, and Richards is going to take advantage here. Now, if Richards is smart, which is a 50-50 gamble anytime, but if Richards is smart, he's going to get Houston over to the Ray Kandrak team corner, just like they had Jason Miller previously. In center ring, in that far corner where he's at, towards the center corner, Houston's got a much better chance of making his partners for the tag. And right here, we do see, finally, the team working together.
Yeah. I mean, like you were saying, especially with that many guys in the corner that can reach out and tag, but they need to stay on that shoulder.
Pretty sure this is the first time that Richards and Kandrak have ever been on the same team. Yeah. They had quite a war back years ago.
Yeah, they're not exactly friends. They both made each other's name off of each other, more or less. I still remember Kandrak gashing Nick Richards' head from ear to ear.
They sent each other to the hospital in the course of that feud.
I always remember the tuxedo street fight. Ray Kandrak had to get splinters underneath, stitches underneath his skin. And they have really got this going in their direction here.
Ryan Zane goes for the cover. Matt Houston's a man. I don't think you want to be doing that kind of stuff to Matt Houston.
No, you might come back with missing some parts, if you know what I mean.
Hits the canvas hard. Oh, my goodness gracious. The Kandrak-led team finally working together here.
He told me he was going to do this. He calls this the embracing arms of Obamacare.
The what?
Oh!
And that is Lewis Moore's response.
Lewis Moore, not a fan of Obamacare. But Ryan Zane, ever the progressive.
Ever the progressive indeed. Miller tags himself back in. You got to think Miller, with everything he throws at Houston, is going to be thinking receipt for when Miller was trapped in the corner just a few moments ago.
Oh, yeah, they're going to attempt to rip that arm out of the socket. Snake eyes.
Dropped him against the buckle. Houston trying to go to the corner. Miller is not letting him go.
And he's got a little bit of a half sleeper, half trap on that arm right now. Good move.
Garcia in. I think Garcia was willing to tag in just to get away from his partner, Ryan Zane. Partner.
Yes.
The air bubbles. Partner.
Yeah, guys, saw the bunny ears. Mm. And Matt Houston fighting back.
You see the pain on his face, but he's a long way from the corner. Those big, oh.
And this is kind of ironic. This is normally a game plan you see from the Outlaws, going after that shoulder.
Yeah, positively. The Outlaws great at dissecting one body part. And in this case, it is Houston that has befallen that.
And I have to give Richards credit. He set all this up. Ah!
Whoa. Garcia trying to draw everybody out of the corner. Robbie Walsh has got to hold back a lot of man right now.
I hope Garcia didn't think Robbie Walsh was going to stop all those guys from coming in.
Discretion a little bit the better part of valor here. Definitely the smarter tactic is to be discretionary and not charge in the ring. Because when you do that, you do your partner a disservice.
You know what? I've seen a lot of Ryan Zane here, you know, from all kidding aside. He's wrestling a good match right now.
Converse now charging in. The Converse Parker Biggs Outlaws team really starting to get frustrated with the Ray Kandrak led team.
And Robbie Walsh has completely lost control of this match.
Matt Houston hurting on the canvas.
Nice armbar.
And they are going to grind Houston down.
Well, he's got that sunk in deep. And you hear the crowd trying to get Matt Houston up. He's got four big, tough guys he could tag if he could get over there.
He's got to get there, though.
It looks like Manny's trying to go to the eyes, maybe. But Matt Houston stopping. He
drills him.
And I think Manny forgot he's got another arm.
Uh-oh.
Super kick.
Put it right on the chin, and this is the biggest opening that Houston has had in several minutes. Aaron Biggs wants the tag. Lewis Moore wants the tag. Rick Converse is looking keenly. Jimmy Parker is staring Ray Kandrak down in the corner.
And we got Richards.
Richards is in.
And Converse.
And Converse is in. He got the tag to Converse.
And Converse cleaning house.
Inverted atomic drop here.
Ooh!
Gorgeous clothesline just about knocked Richards out of his tattered jeans.
He's been wearing those for weeks.
Yes, he has.
Oh! Richards still got some fight.
He's got plenty of fight. Oh! Converse Ooh. Drills him in the face. Could be the Richter scale right here.
Yes.
He's got Richards. Drilled him with the Richter scale. Cover.
Wait, what the?
What is Dakota doing? Chase Dakota just stopped the fall. Dakota's saying that Converse is his partner, not the rest of these guys. Dakota just cost his team a win.
What? Why did Chase Dakota wait till now to bring this up?
What in the world? Well, this thing is breaking down now. We've got bodies flying everywhere.
It's a scrum in the middle of the ring.
Ooh. Clothesline on Kandrak. Bodies are everywhere.
Including over. Get that. And there's just a fight all over the building right now.
Bodies are everywhere. Robbie Walsh has completely lost control. Chase Dakota has completely just thrown this complete bout into disarray here.
We've got a prison riot. Oh, God. Ryan Zane.
Spear. Oh, my God. Spear from Parker. And that's going to do it. Parker's team has won it, but and Dakota has got a lot of angry people to answer to on the floor.
Yeah, this is Dakota's fault.
14 minutes, 24 seconds. Your winners by pinfall, the team of the new era, Jimmy Parker, the first with Converse, Aaron Speaks, and the Bennett Lynn Cowboys.
Well, Chase Dakota may have finally crossed a line here with Converse.
Yep.
Converse continues to lecture Dakota, but Kandrak and Parker staring each other down in the ring. Parker gets the Duke here, and Kandrak is not happy whatsoever.
Well, less happy than usual.
Much different result, me and you. Much different result.